get up about 5,
pop downstairs, do a flask. The wife's done the sandwiches, get my bag ready for work. And then I'll get on my bike about 5 to 6, cycle to work. Takes about 15 minutes. My name's Ronnie Kelp. I work for Amey, and we're in partnership with Wolverhampton City Council, and we collect the waste and recycling for the whole of Wolverhampton. When we're on recycling, there's normally 3 of us, a driver and 2 loaders. Today I've got Glenn. He's loading with me because we don't let him drive because he's not a very good driver. And we got Ken, we let him drive because he's old. We normally meet up, have a quick chat, so we can check the truck over with Ken. Ken will do his logbook and his check sheet for the day. Me and Glenn will scoot around the truck, make sure everything's okay with the tyres, lights, everything like that. As long as the truck's good for the day, we'll use the truck. It's important to have high visibility clothing because a big percentage of the loaders' days that you're working the road. So you want your driver to see you, make sure you're okay, and you want other road users to see you. It's our responsibility to make sure that we take away all the recycling that's out. Our main role is just to make sure that they are full of recycling. What there should be in there is paper, glass jars and bottles, tin cans, cardboard, types of plastic like yoghurt pots and plastic bottles. We visually inspect every bin before we put it on the truck. If there's something that can't be recycled that's in the bin, we can't put it on the truck, so we notify the customer in way of a card. We write on the card what it is or tick what it is. There's little pictures on there that tells you what's in your bin, and we post it for the door. Not only do we inform the customer that we've not taken their bin, it's our duty working for Wolverhampton City Council that we notify our driver who's got an electronic device in the cab. This records what type of contamination was in the bin, the addresses that haven't recycled properly, and it keeps a record of everything that's going on in the city. The most common things that you do find in the bins are black bags and plastic bags, and people tend to throw a lot of food in there, nappies, people put duvets in there, bits of wood, electrical items like small tellies, videos, radios, stuff like that really. One of the most disturbing things I heard about was a boa constrictor. Somebody had put that in the bin, and I found dead cats as well, dead pets, which not really recyclable, are they? Nine times out of ten, you're the first person they're going to come out the house and talk to about why the bin hasn't gone on the truck. So we try and help them and just explain to them what should go in the bin and what shouldn't go in the bin, that's all. You get all sorts of reactions, really. 90% of the people are okay with it. You explain to them what it was and they'll understand it. So then you get the odd few that just shout at it and think, well, I'll pay more council tax. It's your job to take it away. They don't understand that it's got to be recycled, that it needs to be kept clean. We've emptied the bins that we can take and the wagon's full. We take it to our transfer station where it's tipped off the truck onto the floor. Some guys down there, they'll pick as much as they can out, all the bulky items and some of the non-recyclable that we've not been able to see through our visual check, because we want to make it as clean as we can before it goes off to the next process to be sorted into different types. I think the good thing is, when you're with a crew, you get on with that crew, it is nice coming to work, you know, you all look out for each other. I know we're up early, especially like the winter months, it's cold, it's dark, it's wet, but you just get each other through the day really, just having that bit of camaraderie, and you take pride in your job and you want to get on as a crew, you know, you want to have a laugh and a joke, but you do want to get your job done at the end of the day as well. If I was to describe my role in 3 words, I'd say tough but rewarding. You're giving something back, something's going to come back off what you do. Everything they take away and recycle is coming back as something else. So it's got to be a good thing, recycling, hasn't it?